Hello, everyone. Continue to pray for my health, our finances, our roommate situation, for the Lord's will to be done. For my friend Bobby's health, my friend Randy, for energy for him, for my friend Aaron and his finances and his car troubles. If you have prayer, just let me know. Letting Go and Trusting God, 180 Devotions for Life's Tough Decisions by Pamela L. McQuaid. And today's topic is emoticons. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Colossians 3:12. Feeling angry or bitter? Maybe you'd like to slap a false emoticon on your face and pretend you're the ultimate happy Christian. But that... Benji! There they go again. Let me go to the room again. It's dogs, I tell ya. They are turds. Sorry about that. But that cheesy little computer smiley face wouldn't solve the problem. Inside, you'd still feel mad or bitter, and even if you gritted your teeth and said the right thing, others would know you were being a hypocrite as you struggled to show compassion to the person who just took advantage of you or faced off with the coworker who got the job wrong for the third time in a row. God's clothing isn't a cover-up, but a sign of his cleansing. He never calls us to feel an emotion he won't empower us to have. Through this verse, our Lord calls us to choose positive emotions and make them part of our daily existence. That doesn't mean we must grit our teeth and spit out the right words, even though they aren't in our hearts. Such legalism only makes us frustrated. Putting on the clothes of a godly life takes time and means we have to deal with sin. We won't be completely garbed in lovely robes of humility, gentleness, and patience seconds after our conversion, but as we make godly actions our goal and love, our goal and love the Lord who commanded us to have them, they'll slowly become part of our everyday lives. Then we won't need any emoticons or emotions. Our emotions will be true and grounded in the one who gave them to us. What emotions are you choosing today? And that is it. I hope you have a blessed rest of your Saturday. I hope you're having a great weekend. God bless.